torch party is as significant as you would have heard from Hugh's speech before, in the part that the torch played in a legatee's life. When you join Legacy, you're told that you're accepting the torch being handed down from the forebears and the preceding servicemen to you to carry forward at this time. It appears on our badges and all our documentation. This ceremony will see the torch party advance to the stairs here. The junior legatee, Chris Croon, will go down and meet them at the bottom of the stairs, accept the torch, significant of the change, and bring it back up here to the legatee president. The torch party will now advance. And I introduce to as a recitalist from Melbourne High School, having trouble reading my notes with the sunshine up here, Joe Christie, who will read the prayer in Flanders Fields.
In Flanders Fields, the poppies blow. Between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place. And in the sky, the larks, still bravely singing, fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders Fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you, from failing hands, we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders Fields.
Coming to the rostrum now is the school captain of MacRobertson School High School. Mess them up. Sorry, I can't read your name. Can't see it.
Written by Moana Michael, who conceived the idea of using poppies as a symbol of remembrance for all who served in World War I. She wrote this in November 1918, "We shall keep the faith." O you who sleep in Flanders Fields, sleep sweet to rise anew. We caught the torch you threw, and holding high, we keep the faith with all who died. We cherish too the poppy red that grows on fields where valor led. It seems to signal to the skies that blood of heroes never dies, but lends a luster to the red of a flower that blooms above the dead in Flanders Fields. And now the torch and poppy red we wear in honour of your dead. Fear not that ye have died for naught. We'll teach the lesson that ye wrought in Flanders Fields.
My apologies, that was Miss Tracy Truong from MacRobertson Girls High School. And we're rapidly approaching the finale of our ceremony today, so I'd ask you to all stand for the national anthem.
Oh, again. Well, the next thing as the completion of the ceremony comes is the Governor of Victoria will depart down the forecourt to her car down the bottom of the stairs, escorted by Melbourne Legacy President and the Chairman of the Shrine Trustees, Chris Spence. And she'll stop and have a chat with some of the students as she goes past. The first thing will be the guard will give another vice regal salute. On your behalf, I thank our participants who have spoken and conducted various duties today. Yes, I think a round of applause is due. Thank you. And with the completion of our ceremony today, I thank the teachers for making the effort to bring their schools in today in the last week of school. Please enjoy the rest of your day and have a good, safe term break. Thank you.